What's up, all you metal maniacs? I'm back with the second installment of Ned's World of Metal. I know, a long-awaited sequel to a thing that y'all thought may never come. Yes, it is finally here. I've been promising it for so long that it just ended up like one of those movies that end up in development hell. Like, Jurassic Park 4. Anyways, that's besides the topic. I'm Jurassic World, whatever. I've been promising this since the first release of Ned's World of Metal. At first, I said it was a guitar lesson. You want your guitar lesson? Here's your goddamn guitar lesson. I promised the Nazareth song Hair of the Dog that featured on Chan's Rants. I looked over my first episode and realized it kind of didn't make any sense because no one would have gotten it. It's Nazareth's song Hair of the Dog. That you've been expecting for so long. I'm kind of sick right now. My nose is all stuffed up because it's the worst time of the year. People say it's the most wonderful time of the year. It's my least favorite time of year, people. I mean, where's all the metal? Besides on the Christmas trees. I mean, come on, people. The most wonderful time of the year is obviously Halloween. Don't believe me? Ask Rob Zombie. Anyways, I come today to talk about Metallica's new release, Hardwired to Self-Destruct, which I actually did promise this episode at the beginning of November for a review of that album, and I kind of decided maybe I should do something different than just metal CD reviews, because everybody can do a metal album review, no matter how popular I may be, and people may just watch it and get, I don't know, 35 million views, which is not an exaggeration. It is totally an accurate view count. 35 million and counting for my first episode. Anyways, I decided, why don't I just get it over with and just review the goddamn album and then move on to something else besides doing metal album reviews all the time. Why don't I do something different? Something more metal. Something different. Something that goes against the grain. That's the very definition of metal. Anyway, so I decided, you know what, let's just review the dang thing and move on from there. Alright, my overall thoughts on Metallica's new album is gonna be probably a 6 out of 10. That's a bit small. Maybe I should move it to 7. Yeah, the thing is, Metallica is not what they were back in the 80s. Metallica has been a very successful band over the years, with the debut album Kill 'Em All, which is one of their best, Ride the Lightning, which is another great work of metal. In fact, one of Nathan's favorite Metallica albums. Master of Puppets, my ultimate favorite Metallica album. The highly questionable And Justice for All, which was great, but the lacking of bass kind of had a little lacking in me because I like hearing my bass and metal. And then we get to the Black Album, which after that, Metallica wasn't the same. I mean, they had the hit song, Inner Sandman, Nothing Else Matters. Awesome songs, but it's just not the Metallica that us Metallica fans came to love in the first place about Metallica. And then we get to Load, which alienated fans even more, and then we get to Reload, and then we get to Saint Anger, which I can't even describe the disappointment from them. And then we get to Death Magnetic, which was much better than Saint Anger, but wasn't that Metallica that I loved. And then we get to Hardwired to Self-Destruct, which is their new release, which was good, but I have a few problems with. First of all, it sounds cliche. I mean, is no one else hearing this? Iron Maiden released The Book of Souls, which was a pretty long album. Double album at that, which featured a single character and then a completely solid colored background, which was black. We get to Metallica's album, and it's a double album with one single character, which is all the Metallica members smashed into one weird looking creature thing, and then a white background. That's what kind of made me go, this is kind of copying Iron Maiden a little. And then the music, These are some longer songs. They're not as long as Maiden's, but they range to like 7-8 minutes, which at the most is most of the songs on this album. That's kind of, that's my one gripe about it. My other gripe is they sound like they're copying Slayer and Megadeth. Hardwired kind of reminded me of Slayer, and then Spit Out the Bone reminded me of Megadeth, and the music video for it reminded me of Megadeth again. Maybe it's just me. I think it's just me, but I don't know if that's how others feel. But my favorite songs on the album, my notable mentions are Hardwired, Moth Into Flame, which were the two singles released for the album. There's three. Next is Spit Out the Bone and Murder One, which is a tribute to the sadly passed away bassist and lead vocalist of band Motorhead, Lemmy Kilmister, or something like that. I can't pronounce his name. Anyways, my overall thoughts on the album is 7 out of 10. Not the best, but definitely not their worst. I went over the albums again and realized that my favorite album of this year would have to go to Anthrax. Out of the big four, with their new releases, Anthrax had to be my favorite, then Megadeth, and then Metallica, and Slayer. Let's move beyond metal. I mean, not metal. Album reviews. We're moving on to the next thing on the show, which is the body bag count today. This is a new thing I'm going to do on the show called the body bag count, which is some items that I got someone to pick out of Nathan's room, and we're going to talk about it, rant about it, whatever. Okay, the first item, which is pretty large, is a... what is this thing? Oh, it's a Paper Jams guitar. Is this how Nathan learned how to play guitar? Because if he did, I wouldn't be surprised, because he's pretty terrible. Get this junk out of here. Don't tell Nathan. Next item we get to is... what's this? Is this a styrofoam cup? Hooters. Hooters. Who saves a Hooters cup? I don't save the items from Hooters except the napkins that the very attractive waitresses give you. Hooters. Probably the only thing he can remember about him being next to a beautiful chick. Next. What is this? What is this? It's large. Oh my god, is this a dildo? Oh good, it's just a machete. A very nice machete at that. It's been used. On what, murdering people? I might actually borrow this from Nathan. To do some very questionable things. Maybe involving politicians. Moving on. You didn't hear that. I am not going to kill politicians. Or am I? Moving on. What is this? It's an old tape on bass. I wonder whose it is. I don't know any bass players. Except the one in my band. Okay, next item. What is this? What is this? Oh my god, it's an abomination! One of Metallica's worst albums. Well, not their worst. That'd go to Saint Anger, but... this is where Metallica just went bad. And we were just talking about Metallica. What a coincidence. Oh my god. That's a little harsh, because they have a few songs on there that I like. I mean, the entire album I liked. It was okay at most, but I could do without it. What is this thing? Feels like a tail. Oh, it's a headless Godzilla. Would you imagine that? Ooh. Nathan doesn't even take care of his toys. Wait a minute, he plays with toys? What a baby. Ugh. Next. Oh, what's this, another CD? Oh my god, it's hair metal. Who likes hair metal? I like that chick on the album though. But, hair metal, terrible. Terrible, just terrible. I hate hair metal. What's this? Is this another VHS tape? Oh, it's a bunch of bullets. I wonder what Nathan's gonna do with these. What type of bullets are these? Ooh, what's this? Get out, get out. Definitely gonna borrow this for a little while to do some very questionable things. You didn't hear that either. Gosh, I'm gonna end up in prison before I end up on the Hot 100 again. What's this? Is this a toy car? It is a toy car. And it's a toy car that I would actually use. This thing's kinda cool. I'd actually drive a car like that, blow up the street. Hey, I found a use for those bullets already. I'm gonna call a contracting company to make this car built for me. Yeah, hello. I would like a car like this car. What do you mean you can't see it? You want me to send you a picture of it or something? Of course I'm gonna send you a picture of it. God dang it, you people are so dumb. Look at this. Alright, I'm gonna put you on hold. I'm gonna send you a picture. You got it? Good. Because that's a badass car and I want that car built. What do you mean you can't put the machine guns on it? I want machine guns! Oh, I'm so done with you people. Ugh! Next. What is this? Oh my god, what is this thing? Looks like an old banana laid out in the sun and started looking like shit at the end. Ugh. Wait a minute. I think this is a tooth. A tooth to what? I don't know what that nerd has stocked up in his pile back in his room. I don't even want to know. But I'm going through his stuff, so it obviously means I want to know. What's this? Is this a piece of paper? No, I just dropped it. What the? Come on. Come on, come on. Who is this? What do you mean, why am I asking who is this? I want to know who this is. I'm Ned Stanley. I'm the greatest. I'm the best. I'm the best there is. I am the best at what I do and what I do. Wait a minute. Is this a pizza company? Yes, I'd like a Bob Marley extra crispy. You know what I mean. Yeah, you know what I mean. I'm kidding. Goodbye. I didn't know Nathan was into that scene. Okay, the next and final item, I believe. Is this the final item? There's only one item left in there. Come on, oh, this makes up for everything in that bag. This is the best thing in that bag. Ow, I think I got a crank in my neck. Oh. Seriously, this makes up for everything in that bag. That bag is terrible. What do you think about the body bag count now? I think it's a thing I'm going to incorporate on the show now. Just put have someone put some random shit in the bag, and I just pull it out and talk about it, whatever. Alright, moving on. What's the next thing we're going to talk about? We're talking about metal. This is Ned's World of Metal. Let's talk about metal. Okay, I got some metal albums right here, which I recommend. Which I do recommend. This one, Nazareth. You can't go wrong with Nazareth. A very underrated band, but this album sold some records. Anthrax, my favorite metal album of the year. I know I went and said this was not the greatest metal album, and it's not. And I said, is this a great metal album? And I said, kinda, but no, I think this is absolutely the greatest metal album of 2016. Next, we got a live album from Megadeth called Rude Awakening, which is very good. I recommend it. Oh, a great work of metal right here. Ride the Lightning. Oh, another great work of metal right here. Kill Them All. Oh, no, no way. My all-time favorite album of all time. Holy Diver, baby. And we get down to the number of the beast. Hey, it's that time of season. Wait, is it that time of season? I can't remember. Christmas is whenever the devil was born, right? Was the devil born on, you know what? I don't even care. I think I just broke that holy diver. Oh no, I made a crack across it. Look at that. Oh my god. I'm a very bad person. Oh, you're still here? You're not bored through this episode? Because I am. I don't know what else to do for it. The highly anticipated Ned's World of Metal episode 2. Ned don't even know what the hell he's gonna do. Typical Ned.